Welcome back to a new video lecture, and in this lecture we will discuss about the fixed end moment values for various types of loadings. Okay, so actually what do you mean by this fixed end moments and why we are using? We already derived the slope deflection equation formula, and in that case we have determined in that equation there is a term called MFAB, that is fixed end moment value. So here in this lecture we will note down which are the different values for this fixed end moments for the various loading conditions. And the first case we will discuss when a UDL is acting. Okay, actually this is happen in a continuous beam, and in the first step we note down that we are transferring, we are converting this into fixed end, both ends to be fixed. Okay, so here you can note down that if a UDL is acting over a fixed beam, then the fixed end moment value is going to be, if it is anti-clockwise, then it is minus WL square by 12, and if it is clockwise, then it is WL square by 12. So we are not going into the derivation part of how this formula is going to happen. Okay, actually if you know this value, just substitute while doing problems. If you know this value, then just substitute the values. And the second condition or second case is that when a point load is acting at the center of the beam, that means this W is acting at the center, then the fixed end moment value is going to be minus WL by 8, and here it is clockwise, then it is WL by 8. And the third condition or third case is that when this point load is not acting at the center, it is not acting exactly at the center, some distance A and B from each supports, then the value is going to be minus WAB square by L square, and here positive WL square B by L square. So this is the condition. Okay. And when a UVL is acting over the beam, when a UVL, that means a UD uniformly varying load is acting, then the fixed end moment values MFAB is equal to minus WL square by 30, and here it is WL square by 20. Okay, this is the condition for this when a UVL is acting. And here the UVL is acting in this pattern. If the UVL is acting in this pattern, the fixed end moment value is going to be minus 5 by 96 WL square. Then here it is positive 5 by 96 WL square. So this is the various cases which we need to work out while doing the slope deflection equations. Okay, so if we know this fixed end moment value, then you can easily substitute in the equation and solve the problem very easily. So I hope the section is clear, and with this we'll wind up today's section. Thank you.